JazakAllah Mirza Maghfoor Sahib for a very considerate presentation of the aims and purposes of Masih Maud al-Islam, and that is why we are here today and this weekend anyhow. A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. You know, the Jalsa is coming to a conclusion for this year, but in some ways it doesn't go away. When we come together as we have done this weekend, you know, the memories of being here, of listening to speeches, of interaction with each other, mashallah, there are 7,000 plus people who attended this year, but even so, there was enough of an interaction. We would remember, you know, those who we met and the things that we talked about and things that we are going to follow up as we go through the rest of the year, hopefully till next year when we meet again. The message of Masih Maud alayhi salam is for the next 1,000 years. His writings and statements, they are going to be subject to interpretations as we go along. They will apply to the circumstances differently because life is not uniform, and by its very definition, things change. And the need for what understanding we must have, that changes. Life is also not in the control of one person. God Himself controls everything. There are smaller issues which arise, which we seem to have some handle on them. But at a deeper level, Allah Ta'ala Himself, He is working through His angels about the very conception of each one of us from way back, and it keeps on going forward. And He influences and affects circumstances in ways where we cannot object to His doings in any way. We only have to worry about what we can do as we go along. Khalifatul Masih al-Khamis sent us a message, a very exhaustive message, which was read at the beginning of the meeting, and I believe most people are familiar with it, although some people were not there at the opening. I'm not going to read the message in its entirety, but I'll just skip through it to highlight a few things. One thing that he is talking about very consistently is the need and the importance of paying attention to his khutbat. Hazrat Sahib's khutbat, they are not put there casually. He puts a lot of, you know, focus on what he's saying because he realizes that the Jamaat now is spread all over the world. It's not like it used to be when most of us, we were in Rabwa, and there was a time when Khalifatul Masih would interact in a different way, in a more local way. That option is not there very much. There's very limited scope of that, you know, in England or when he travels overseas. But the vast expanse of the Jamaat, which literally now spans the entire globe, requires that everybody throughout the world pay attention to what he's saying. Now we have the benefit of MTA for the last more than a decade now, where we are able to receive the khutbat of Khalifatul Masih regularly and even as it happens. I think in America we are even more fortunate because our setup, I believe, is multifaceted. It's through the direct satellite transmission. It's through the web. And there's an ability to obtain the khutbat even afterwards through the use of the internet. It's quite convenient. Now, I realize some people might not have the broadband internet, but most people do. So we should pay close attention to what he is saying. What he says has vast consequences for how the Jamaat will shape up. It has very deep consequences for how the word of Ahmadiyya, the message of the Messiah, will spread. It is dependent upon how we pay attention to the khutbat, and then we try to reflect on them and try to apply the issues that he is raising to our own circumstances. Now, our individual circumstances would vary some, but by and large, the things that he's asking for are quite straightforward, saying honesty, hard work, you know, loyalty to your country, you know, fellow mankind, be attentive to what their concerns are. You could do it only in a limited fashion, and that's all right, but do it. You know, do a little bit if you can do only a little bit. But be kind to our neighbors, be kind to the man in the street that you interact with, and work with the system of government and the politics that we have in America, which is a good system. You can say it's not perfect, but it's a good system. And we need to work with it, and that's the only way we can accomplish the purposes that the Messiah, al-Islam, has laid out for us. I'm trying to put it in a nutshell. You know, his message is about 4 pages long. I don't want to start reading it again. However, it will get printed, and it will be in the Gazette so that, you know, individuals can access it. The opportunity also requires me to acknowledge the work of a lot of people. Now, you know, I'm aware of not of everything, but I'm aware of a lot of work which goes on. At this Jalsa and throughout the year, you know, we are by and large a volunteer organization, and there is a unique flavor to being a volunteer organization. We also have, you know, full-time workers, missionaries, that's what we call them, murabbis we call them, and they are, mashallah, doing a good job, and, you know, God bless them for everything that they do and help them. We have teams working here at the Jalsa. They have been working for quite some time in order to make this gathering happen. And I am told and I'm aware of teams staying up to the wee hours of the morning in order to settle down everything which had been done the day before and to be ready for the day to come on the next day. So they do it for the love of it. They do it for the favor of Allah. They do it because they like to work together with each other. There's blessing in that camaraderie. And may Allah bless them all and take care of them. And may their tribe increase. I have to borrow an expression. But I hope that they keep on increasing and growing and flourishing, inshallah. The summary of the attendance is something like this. I'm given a total of 7,000 plus people who attended the Jalsa this year, mashallah. Out of that, 3,100 plus are ladies and 3,700 plus are gentlemen. and the total number of guests are 336, and these are from 17 countries. I know they are from Myanmar, they are from Guatemala, they are from Bangladesh, they are from Pakistan, of course, we have them. We have a lot of, you know, guests from Canada, mashallah. Some from England, from the European countries. They're all welcome. We're happy they were here with us. And with that, I'm going to conclude and ask you to join me in silent prayers. Now, the prayers are very important. You know, you might not see the, you know, see us rising in a spaceship, you know, as we pray. That's not the way it works. But the prayers, they work. There is no way around it. And Allah Ta'ala will listen to your prayers. And Masih Maud al-Islam has used a lot of expressions at the remarking at the end of the Jalsa in his lifetime, where he said that, you know, all those who are here, may they travel back in safety, may their worries and their sorrows, their gham o ham, that may Allah relieve them, may Allah take care of them, and help all of you in all different ways as you travel to your homes and throughout the year and thereafter as well.